for the final time of asking. It's the title decider in Moto2, and we are underway. Great start from pole position. He sweeps to the left-hand side of the circuit there, doesn't he, the pole man, Alonso Lopez, quickly followed by the man second, Pedro Acosta, who's got a really good launch off the line. Tony Arbolino is away strongly as well from the second row. He's immediately up into third.
Crucial start for Ayagura. He's got past Pedro Acosta. In fact, no, it's Fernandez back there in fifth. So Ayagura is now the leader of our championship contenders. It's the first two off the grid who remain first and second ahead of Arbolino, but crucially, Ayagura ahead of Fernandez.
Just the start Ayagura wanted. He would have dreamt of that moment last night. He got the perfect launch, dropped the clutch at the ideal time there. Now he's already trying to find a way through Antonio Arbolino. Oh, that was Aldegate, very aggressive on the inside of Fernandez. He picks up the man leading the world championship into turn five. Fernandez then back into six. We're about to get lap number one complete here in our Moto2 title decider. Is it going to be Lopez or Acosta that leads up? It will be Pedro Acosta by a whisker. He got the slipstream behind Lopez. Simone Corsi's Grand Prix career comes to a frustrating end. The 35-year-old, his 320th Grand Prix start, he is down out. Fernandez responds on Aldegate. That was beautifully done. Aggressive on the inside of his fellow countryman.
Look at that from Lopez.
Well, Lopez just runs Acosta out to the paintwork there.
And Ayagura through to second now as he takes advantage of that. That's not going to be good news for Augusto Fernandez. If Ayagura finishes in second in this Grand Prix, Fernandez has to be fifth or better. He's currently fifth. This leading group of five are pulling away, but Ayagura is having to defend this. He can't let Arbolino get too far in front, but he's under immense pressure now.
Yeah, Lopez on the inside of Ayagura into first corner. As he made that stick, no, he just runs a little bit wide. Ayagura pinches the inside line back and retakes second place. Time for mental maths, isn't it now, for Augusto Fernandez, trying to work out exactly how the championship sits. Well, we can tell him on screens, nothing between them, just half a point as it stands right now, the gap between Fernandez and Ayagura.
Well, Acosta looked like he was showing a front wheel there to Ayagura. He's got to be very, very careful there as Lopez once again up the inside of Pedro Acosta. He's set on Friday. He's highly motivated to win the Rookie of the Year prize. Well, there's your proof of it. That's the second time he's punted Pedro out of the way.
This has been a star ride from the man with the stars and stripes American livery, hasn't it? Cambobia, 13th. He started this 25-lap Grand Prix, picked his way through. Oh, that's going to be close. How close was that? Heart in the mouth stuff here between Arbolino and Ayagura again, just as it was in Sepang 2 weeks ago. Both wheels sideways.
It's like,
Bobier's gone down. Well, that's going to certainly ease the pressure and tension on Augusto Fernandez. Pedro Acosta thought about a lunge on the inside of Ayagura into the first corner, but that was so, so tight. Big risk being taken by Ayagura, as he has to take. Both wheels, as we said, sliding down the hill, speedway style into turn number 14. He came through, Bobier didn't. Bobier's Moto2 career sadly ends in the gravel. Vietti then, that is now a 6th DNF in the last 9 Grand Prix. He's been wanting the end of this 2022 World Championship for quite some time. What a horrendous second half of the season for the Italian. Looked like a world title contender, didn't he, up until the summer break at the Sachsenring and Aston time. Since then, it has been an unmitigated disaster for Vietti. He started the season so strongly with a win from pole in Qatar. He's ending it in bitterly disappointing fashion. Back at the front of this Grand Prix then, it will be Arbolino that leads Ayagura and Acosta down the hill. Nothing between the top three in a turn number 14. A bit of a gap then back down to Augusto Fernandez, who's had the pressure eased on him somewhat after Cambobier's mistake on the previous lap into turn number 14. Over the line we go then to start lap 8 of 25. Here comes Acosta. Now this is going to put a massive smile on the face of Augusto Fernandez, because he will know that's 4 more points taken away from his closest title rival, Japan's Ayagura.
Ayagura's going to fight back straight away here. Here he comes, look, up the inside into turn 2. This is where Pedro Acosta was taken out of the Moto3 Grand Prix here last year by Dennis Foggia, and Ayagura regains second place. As I said a lap or two ago, it's pass or be passed. Yeah, here comes Acosta again.
Brilliant into turn number 4, but Ayagura leans on him, squeeze him out of the paintwork. This is brilliant action, is it, between Ayagura and Pedro Acosta. This is a taste of what's to come in 2023 as well, isn't it? There'll be 2 top men in next year's Moto2 World Championship. Will Ayagura, they'll be back as the defending world champion. That's only happened once before, hasn't it? Well, twice with Tito Rabat and Gianzarco. Now then, this... Oh, no, Ayagura's got down! And that is it! That is... is game over. The Moto2 World Championship is gone. Can you believe it? Head in hands, tears of despair start flowing down in Idemitsu Honda Team Asia, because for the second time in two Grand Prix, Ayagura makes big, big mistakes. He goes down at turn number eight, right in front of Augusto Fernandez, who can now just cruise. Augusto Fernandez, congratulations to him. He's the 2022 Moto2 World Champion.
And he doesn't need to finish this Grand Prix now. He will have seen that up ahead of him. The team are letting him know on his dashboard. There will also be a pit board out there. You can see it on the bottom, 79KO, which will be the letters and numbers that Augusto Fernandez will have been desperate to see early in this Grand Prix. He can just enjoy now these final 17 laps of this Grand Prix, and desolation at Honda Team Asia. Crashes in each of the last two Grand Prix for Ayagura.
Here he goes then, it's into the fast turn seven initially, isn't it? Then on the brakes, going to turn eight, he lost that so early. Almost as soon as he started tipping in and squeezing the brakes, look at that. You don't see that crash that early, do you, going into turn eight? It happened. They don't need to put the pit board out, do they, for Augusto Fernandez? He was just metres behind that key moment. That is the decisive, defining moment of this Moto2 World Championship in 2022. Ayagura has crashed out. There is the realisation that they'll have to wait one more season at least for Ayagura to win the Moto2 Championship. Utter despair and dejection for Idemitsu Honda Team Asia. He's put up a fantastic fight for glory this year has Ayagura, but he's just going to come up short. Crucial mistakes when he reflects on what's been an excellent season. He threw it all the way in Sepang, and he threw it all the way again here today in Valencia. Bunching up now, isn't it, between Arbolino and the rebel KTM Ayagura, Pedro Acosta and Augusto Fernandez.
Yeah, his pace is just dropping off a little bit at this stage of the race. Is Arbolino after that incredible electric start to the Grand Prix. He did a 135.8 on the last lap around. Both Acosta and Fernandez were half a second faster than him. You feel like Acosta, and particularly Fernandez, can afford to be a little bit patient with this now. They've closed the gap so quickly. Acosta always gets good drive out of that final corner, which enabled him to pass Agoura a few laps ago into turn one, and he's now pulling out of the slipstream once again. Acosta looking to pull alongside and into the lead ahead of Arbolino.
Yeah, listen to the support, the roar from the Valencia crowd. They want to see a home crowd hero win this final Grand Prix of 2022. And that's exactly the position that Pedro Acosta has put himself in.
Just to compound the agony for Japanese Moto2 fans, Taiga Harder, who's running at the back of the field, he's been given a long lap penalty for a yellow flag infringement. Presumably he overtook someone into the yellow flag zone, at which Ayagura had earlier crashed in. And an update on one of our other earlier crashes, Celestino Vietti, he had rejoined the race. He was then shown the black flag with the orange disc, presumably some damage to his bike following that crash. He has now pulled into the pits and retired.
Yeah, pulled into the pits to complete a dismal ending to 2022, isn't it, for the Italian? It's going to be tough for him to bounce back from this. Here comes Fernandez on the inside of Arbolino. There was room there, and boy, did he take it. He sweeps up into second place there now, as he can try and hunt down his teammate Pedro Acosta. Acosta, while Fernandez worked out the puzzle to find a way through on Arbolino, has established a lead now of nearly three quarters of a second, halfway around this lap 13 of 25. Aaron Canet then, he was really starting to close in on Tony Arbolino, hoping for a podium in his home Grand Prix, but it slips through Canet's fingers, as it so often has done in 2022. Into turn five he goes, lose the front end of that Flexbox HP40 machine. So Canet's up and down, inconsistent season ends in a pile of dirt and gravel at turn five. A shake of the head from the Flexbox HP40 squad. Pedro Acosta will win the final Grand Prix in 2022, but it's a rise Augusto. He's the new king in Moto2. Augusto Fernandez, congratulations. He's the 2022 Moto2 World Champion here in Valencia. He takes it with a second place behind his teammate Pedro Acosta. Phenomenal Fernandez then, yet again in 2022. Tony Arbolino does finish the season, an excellent conclusion to the year for him. He's third. Fermin Aldegate comes over the line in fourth place. I think that equals his career best finish. Arenas fifth, Gonzalez sixth, but Augusto Fernandez, he is our new Moto2 world champion. Rebel KTMI, hold on to the crown. The tears will start flowing. Emotional scenes here for Augusto Fernandez. Congratulations to him and to Aki Ayo. World champions yet again.